pro shops. So much dancing, especially out of you. Will you hit the...
Yeah, I'm over here getting... You know I'm a cheer dad. So I got to bring it. I bring it, too. Wait till I show y'all my video. Put a video. Me and my daughter did a video.
YouTube.
Routine. Whole routine. Paul,
Michael Robinson and Mike Garofalo. I'm in for Colleen Wolf. She is getting her Z's ready. She's probably not sleeping. She's probably preparing.
No, nope, she's out. Because she... Out cold.
Oh, come on. She'll be with you guys at 7 a.m. Eastern tomorrow ahead of the Texans-Jags game in London. Let's kick it off right now with the Vikings, though. They are winners of four straight. Is there a hotter team in the NFL? They've taken down the Giants, the Eagles, the Lions, and the Redskins. The biggest reason why? The impossibly incredible play from their quarterback, Kirk Cousins. Since being called out by Adam Thielen week four, Cousins has been on fire. They won last week without Adam Thielen, and tomorrow they head to Kansas City. We head, though, first to Eagan, Minnesota, where our girl, Stacey Dale, has more.
The 6-2 Vikings know they have a big opportunity to kick off the second half of their season on the road this weekend against the Chiefs. And hearing from quarterback Kirk Cousins, the NFC Offensive Player of the Month for October, 10 touchdowns and over 1,200 pass yards in the month of October. He noted, this game is a great test for our football team. But he also said, we have everything to prove. The next 8 games, he said, they will tell the story. We get the job done, that'll be the narrative. But if we don't, that will also be the narrative. He noted that all the work is ahead of this team, and the challenge is on this team to prove that it deserves and belongs to be in the playoff discussion at the end of the season. Something that may help their opportunity, they have the league's best rusher, 823 yards on the ground for Dalvin Cook this season, over 1,100 scrimmage yards. That also leads the league. Facing just the 27th rush defense in the NFL on Sunday against the Chiefs.
Stacey, wish you were here in studio, but you're excited to break down this game. We're still waiting to hear about the reigning MVP, Patrick Mahomes. He's listed officially as questionable. He did practice a little bit this week after dislocating his kneecap back in week 7. We'll see whether it's him or whether it's Matt Moore starting for Kansas City at home. But Mike Robb, they have lost 3 straight at Arrowhead. It's supposed to be one of the scariest places to play. What are you looking for in this matchup?
Yeah, I'm looking for Tyreek Hill and the opportunities that he creates for everybody else. I don't think it matters that much. It does matter, but not that much who's playing quarterback, because the speed and the versatility at which Tyreek Hill adds to this offense is phenomenal. You look at right here, look at all the eyeballs that are on Tyreek Hill as he screams down the middle of the field. It literally creates a screenplay for Sammy Watkins. Now, I don't think the play was designed to be this way. It was just the fact that he's that fast. Again, watch this safety, D-Hall. See how that safety doesn't leave the hash? Well, guess what? That little bit of hesitation was the difference that would not allow him to get there. Those are the type of opportunities that having Tyreek Hill on your team, those are the type of opportunities that he creates. That's why you understand why this team stuck with him through thick and thin, why this team paid him. He creates so much offense for other people. It's crazy.
Well, you talk about creating offense. I got one of the other guys who creates just instant offense as well. It's Dalvin Cook. When you think about Dalvin Cook, Alexander Mattison, this Minnesota rush attack. Well, not even a rush attack, but just those two backs and what they mean to Kirk Cousins. We're talking about Kirk Cousins being in the MVP conversation because he's playing great. Mm-hmm. But part of the reason he's playing great is because he can just hand the ball off to both of these guys. And it's not just Dalvin Cook. Like I said, Alexander Mattison, when he comes in the game, Oh, he's a difference maker. He is a game changer. He runs the ball hard. Every runner, every guy who's trying to tackle him feels him at the point of contact. And then you think about Dalvin Cook in the passing game as well. He's second on the team in receptions. Another 300 yards he's added to the almost 900 he has rushing. Madison, 330-some yards rushing. So these are two guys who bring instant energy and explosiveness to that Minnesota offense.
Dalvin Cook has at least 7 rushing touchdowns in the last 8 games. So not at least, 1 in each game, pretty much. And he's doing it through the air, too, which I love that you're pointing out, because I feel like he doesn't get enough respect in that area. Kirk Cousins, just 1 interception over the last 6 games. You know Kirk Cousins.
Kirk Bone.
Is this sustainable? I know he's balling right now. We've seen him ball week to week. Is this the real deal all of a sudden right now?
I think it is sustainable. Kurt's at his best when he's not asked to throw the ball 50 times a game. And a lot of times in Washington, that's what we made him do. A lot of times in Minnesota, he was doing that. But now, with Dalvin Cook being healthy, Madison being that change of pace guy who can give Dalvin Cook a break sometimes, this offense is looking very explosive.
He's in a complimentary role.
Yes.
Not being the show of the offense. Just because you make $84 million.
What happens when he becomes the show?
When he becomes the show.
You tell me.
Does he have to become the show?
No, he doesn't.
They lose?
They lose. Think about it. I mean, what happened in Washington? Whenever they were leaning on just him to win games with his arm,
but
they
why?
Didn't win big games.
It creates more opportunities for him to make mistakes.
Yeah.
I don't understand.
All of that. But when you're running the football and you make the quarterback complimentary to that, then yeah, I'm just going to run the football until you stop it. When you stop it, it's one-on-one on the outside. I'm an NFL quarterback. Go make the play.
And Kurt's an athletic quarterback that doesn't get credit for being as athletic as he is. So he loves when he can play action, can kind of get moving around that pocket, can run some boots, some different things that you can really only do successfully when you have a really good run game. And so that's why he struggled at times.
I agree. I just wanted them to make their points. That's all. I get what they're saying.
But I think we're seeing a different Kirk Cousins too, Jeezy. I don't think this is the
Kirk Cousins. So you think this Kirk Cousins is different than before?
Like I said, my only problem with Kirk when he was in Washington was Kirk always wanted to be someone else. He wanted to be Aaron Rodgers. He wanted to throw the ball all over the field all the time. And I think now he understands that's not my game. I'm comfortable being who I am. I got my money. I've got my respect. Now let's win some games. Let's try to get this thing going in the right direction. And so, yes, everybody wants to be the highest paid guy, but not everybody can handle all the pressure just falling on you. Kirk's one of those guys. He doesn't need all that pressure for him to be great. He needs to be
if they beat
complimentary.
The Chiefs with Matt Moore under center, it still does not convince me he can win the big game in primetime.
No, it doesn't.
They have a game with the Cowboys, I think, coming up.
Yeah.
They've got a primetimer coming up. You win that game, then you have
if they run the football in that game, Kirk Cousins will win it.
Okay.
Like, that's just the way it goes. It's like we give the quarterback credit when the team wins the game, and we give them all the negative stuff when they lose.
And speaking of NFL media, just
know,
in general,
right?
Media of any kind.
Speaking of Matt Moore, we're still waiting on official word for Patrick Mahomes.
Okay.
But if you're the Chiefs, you've got to take into account this Minnesota front that you're going to be potentially going against. And Danielle Hunter, his ability to get after it, and Everson Griffin. All these guys are Linval Joseph. I mean, they've got the guys up front. They wanted to see Mahomes' mobility in practice.
Mm-hmm.
He showed them a good bit, but I think he's still not a top form.
Don't put him against this guy.
Well, whether Mahomes plays or not, the Chiefs offense needs to get back on track. They went from averaging 34 points in September to just 23 in October. Not their month, and that's not the only drastic decline. Yards per game, big plays, also down.
The blueprint was put out on them.
It's all about